Let's do it. There are some people, though, that cannot identify with the average, ordinary problems of human beings because they think money makes them a superior person. You know why these people think? They think like this. Good money. The money you get for prostituting yourself That's not good money. And I don't mean prostituting your body, I mean prostituting your fucking morals. Right? This is the fucked up part about politicians. They sell parts of themselves that a prostitute can't. Right? She's out on the street and people judge her for selling her body, but you know what? She just sold her body. She didn't sell her soul, motherfucker. These motherfuckers sold their soul. How dare you criticize anybody else? Huh, that's fine. Where are we taking them? Is that where we going? Mira, we're gonna leave the sanctity and the safety of Washington, D.C. We're gonna take you to South America, Central America, Africa, the so-called third world that's not poorer than here. They got just as much wealth, it's just in resources, and we happen to steal those resources. But those countries aren't poor, motherfucker, they're rich as hell. Let's take them, trap this shit, turn it up. Ever since we went to Standing Rock, we don't throw water no more, we go. Put your fucking hands up! Put your hands up! Put your fucking hands up! Put your hands up! Put your fucking hands up! Put your hands up! Put your fucking hands up! I'll from where the golden dollar is a brick for the earth. Fix that slave castle where the water is cursed. From where police brutality stops half in sight. It makes the hood in America look like paradise. Compared to Asia, that's the Caribbean song. African streets with a passport and American gun. From where they massacre people and try to keep it quiet. Disappointed about 8 years ago when the anti-war protests ended, but the war didn't end. I was disturbed to watch the apathy of people that called themselves so-called revolutionaries and progressives cheer somebody getting a Nobel Peace Prize when their drones are still killing children.
Fuck yeah.
Remember something. We're not the fringe, we're the conscience of this country. When people say, oh, well, you can't possibly believe that, that's not what, I'm sorry, the morals that you preach aren't compatible with the reality that you expect us to accept. That's what we're talking about, ladies and gentlemen. They want to make you feel like you're the one that doesn't fit, like you're the one that doesn't belong. You're not here because of whatever. You're here right now because you rejected the programming as a fucking kid. I'm sorry. I don't believe that. I think that's bullshit. I want to question authority. I shouldn't just fucking believe whatever niggas tell me. We're not the freaks. We're the conscience of America. We're the people that remind them this is what you said on this piece of paper that made this whole shit valid, and now this is invalid. So guess what, motherfucker? You're invalid. You ready for doing this? This next track was produced by the late, great Jay Dilla.
Check it out, it out. Dilla.
Rest in power, Dilla.
Bring you the motherfucking moon storm.
Big shout out, Mama Yancy, we love you. Rest in power, Dilla. Lyrics to stay alive in a song, so you'll always keep a piece of my spirit inside when you struggle to complete what I started before I died. But some of you won't survive the changes the earth makes, swallowed by tsunamis, hurricanes, and earthquakes. And that's just the first stage. If you cannot reverse ways and realize that we are one regardless of our birthplace. I want to say a very special thank you to the people who do not come from the undocumented community but are willing to stand in front of that bullet for those people, because they know that immigrants may not run America, but we make America run, motherfucker. And we have bled our soul over this country. I want to say a very special thank you to the people that stand with those who don't look like you, but know that you're like them on the inside, and you stand in solidarity with those people. We need more of that. We need to support each other's causes. I've been out to Standing Rock. I went out to Ferguson. It is important for us to remember that we can learn something from anybody's struggle. It doesn't matter what walk of life they are. And also, if you've lived next to a people for almost 500 years, and you know nothing about them, that doesn't say anything about them. That says something about you. You ready? You ready? Listen, my name is Immortal Technique. I'm the baby of hip-hop. I'm the MC, the baby of hip-hop. He was the one who came last. Spoiled little motherfucker, right? He was just on the mic hyping up the DJ in the 80s, and then he thought he was the fucking star. Before me, in the elements of hip-hop, come the graph writer and the b-boy. Big shout to everybody keeping the culture of hip-hop alive. Thank you very much. But let's keep it 1,000, brothers and sisters. Hip-hop started. Hip-hop started with the motherfucking DJ. DJ. So even though this table has the stability of Trump's ego, my brother is about to tear this shit the fuck up. And if it jumps a little, don't be mad. I want to introduce my brother, representing the Bronx, representing Ghana, West Africa, representing the stronghold of Rebel Arms. Make some noise for my brother, the one and only world famous DJ Static. Listen, no disrespect, but he just showed y'all the difference between a real DJ and a clown that presses a button on the fucking radio. It's kind of like the difference between being a sperm donor and being a real fucking father, and the difference is you gotta put in work, motherfucker! You ready to take it there? Let's take it there. I did this song a long time ago with my friend DJ Green Lantern and the one and only Mos Def. Make some noise for DJ Green Lantern and Mos Def. Y'all seen them? I hope y'all seen them. And it went a little something like this.
Man, you hear this bullshit they be talking?
Take them back.
Every day, man. It's like these motherfuckers is just like professional liars. You know what I'm saying? It's wild.
Listen, blow up the projects. It was you, nigga.
Tell the truth, nigga.
What?
Tell the truth, nigga.
What?
Gave a billion dollars and they funded his purpose. Fahrenheit 9/11.
some fucking noise, DC. Hold on a second. I want to ask y'all something, because I only have a few songs left. I want to ask you a question. Have you ever been at a party or at a club, and you dancing with someone you really like? You know what I mean? No matter who it is, love has no color, love has no gender. We're going to fuck who you with. It's not my place to ask y'all niggas what y'all doing. Not anybody else's place to judge. They not God. Have you ever been dancing with someone you want to fuck with, you like? And then the beat is hot, right? You're moving. And then while you're moving to the beat, you realize that the person who's singing the song isn't saying a fucking thing. Right? We've all had this. So right now, we're going to remove the tightrope. We're going to remove the safety net. We're going totally acapella so you can hear every fucking bar that I have. This is from a song called The Moment of Peace, and it's about the words that people misuse in our society. So check it. When I say autistic, I don't mean retarded, but a genius light in a world of darkness. But regardless, the world is heartless. Cell phone targets for bombardments. I'm out of shits I used to give. So close to death, I see the lives I used to live. My future kids, I leave them with this tutelage. When I say hip hop, I don't mean the music. I mean the culture, not the vultures. They're an ulcer. Fucking devils smell like sulfur. Fearless when I spit the flow. Talk with my hands like Cicero. And it won't be funny like Piscopo, cause romance and death is miserable. Someone gonna die, make the shit to go. I'm hungry and invincible. One nation indivisible, betrayed by individuals. Descended to the criminals that pretended to be biblical and hide behind residuals. So I'm critical of those bankrupt in their spiritual. Double time, double tap, pop the Nina. Collapse your lungs like emphysema. I light one up with your subpoena, cause I glow like fish from Fukushima. I sing like Christians in the arena, fed to the lions and hyenas, massacred like Indonesia. Gone are the days of Iwo Jima. Cause the surge wasn't just troops that we sent to Iraq. It was the surge in money. We paid rebels not to shoot back. That's not victory, but it's history. And liberty's slope is slippery. More miscarriage than delivery. Genocide grows like old hickories. The green leaves are made of bigotry. So the Fed Reserve ain't shit to me. It's symmetry to tyranny with freedom as its imagery. So I'm firing artillery at every possibility. When my moment comes, fuck sympathy. You just keep fighting with dignity. I love you. Let's go. We're now officially in the championship rounds, ladies and gentlemen. We've gotten past the first few rounds. We know this fight is down to the finish line. God damn, please no fake smoke. That better be real smoke. Real smoke. We don't like no fake smoke. I hate fake smoke. That shit is disgusting. I only like real smoke. It's not that healthy, too. Thank you for reminding me, hun. I appreciate you, too. I love you. I'm struggling not trying to eat red meat, too. Niggas laugh because I'm there like, ain't you the motherfucker that wrote beef and broccoli? I'm like, yeah, motherfucker, but people change, right? I'm trying to live to be 80, 90 years old. I'm not trying to eat street meat and die at like 40. Nah, fuck that. We want to live, don't we? We got the right to healthy food in our neighborhood, right? We got the right to eat organic shit just because we can't afford it. Poor, we deserve to die of cancer. What the fuck is that? Y'all ready? Let's count them down from three. Ready? Three, two, one. Come on, DC, you already know this one. Say it. Living in the hole, looking at the world through a crack. But fuck that, I'd rather shoot it now and get clapped. I'm going too far, ain't no coming back for me. Auschwitz gas chamber full of Cyclone B. Just like the Spanish exterminating titles, raping the black and Indian women, creating Latinos. Motherfuckers made me out of self-righteous hatred. Now you got this other virus stuck in the mainstream. Suicide bomber, strapped and ready to blow. Lethal injection, strapped down, ready to go. Don't you understand? Don't never let me live out of peace. Concrete a war out in the streets. Nat Turner with the single pitchfork and machete. End of the world, motherfucker, you not ready. This is the point of no return, nobody can stop it. Malcolm Little Wayne, we knelt before Elijah Muhammad. The comedy kill the dinosaurs, changing the earth. They love to criticize, always say I change for the worse. Egyptian pills when you misusing them, nigga. Templar Knights when they took Jerusalem, nigga. And figured out what was buried under Solomon's temple. Al-Aqsa, the name is not coincidental. I know too much, government trying to murder me. So coming back like cutting your wrists open vertically. I'm the deserving, be purposely put in charge of the country. Genetic engineered sickness spread amongst me. My people are so hungry, they attack without reason. What the fuck you do? Ripping off the head that feeds them. I'm on technique. Treason to the Patriot Act. Come and get me, motherfucker. I'm not coming back. This is a point from which I can never return. I'll back down now, forever I burn. This is a point from which I can never retreat. If I turn back down, it would never be peace. This is a point from which I'll die and succeed. Live in a struggle. I know I'm alive, but I bleed from that war. Songs, I gotta get out of here because they're about to. Can I do another one? Yeah, one more, two more. It's so crazy, it's hilarious. It's now 12 o'clock, which means that several racist people outside have turned into a trumpkin. People are so creative, yo. I love that. You know, right-wing comedy sucks. Like, it's not that we're biased. It's just terrible, yo. You ever been to one of those shows? I'm just saying. Thank you very much. You ready for that? Are you ready for that? Okay. Listen. How many of y'all have been with me for a long time, and you got the Martyr album, the free album? Thank you. If you don't, you can get it for free, viperrecords.com. How many of y'all been with me a little bit longer and you got the Third World? Make some fucking noise. Thank you very much. For those of you that don't know, we took a big percentage of the proceeds from the Third World. We partnered with a human rights organization known as omeid.org, O-M-E-I-D.org, and we used the proceeds to build an orphanage and a school in Afghanistan. So thank you very much. You are all a part of that. No corporate funding. No military funding, no. I didn't even check in with the embassy, which wasn't recommended, but I... but I was embraced by the people, so I felt the safest I've ever felt in my life. I'm saying, you got like a dozen battle-hearted Afghan niggas with you, you kind of feel invincible for a little while, you know what I mean? Like, damn, these niggas beat the Russians, they beat America, they beat everybody up. Like, their great-great-grandparents beat the shit out of Alexander the Great's people. I'm good, bro. I'm good. I was over there like... And I always remember the nigga at the military checkpoint had a Red Sox hat on, and I had the Yankee shit in my day. I said, everywhere you go, everywhere you fucking go, even in the mountains of Afghanistan, you ain't shit. Oh, man. How many of y'all been with me a little bit longer, and you got that Revolutionary Volume 2? It's a shocker, you know what I mean?
Yes!
Listen, how many of y'all been with me? Some of y'all got that. How many of y'all been with me for mad long? Listen, if you've been with me for mad long, you know what? You own the number one most pirated independent album of all fucking time, Revolutionary Volume 1. Listen, I tell you right now, I wear that as a badge of honor. That honor doesn't belong to a punk rock band. It doesn't belong to an alternative hip-hop band. It belongs to underground hardcore hip-hop. And if you never heard of me until tonight, do me a favor. Go home and steal all of my motherfucking music off the internet. And if you like it, support us. And I appreciate you coming through. I'm going to be right there by the edge of the bar just signing autographs after the show, like 10, 15 minutes after the show, because we are not afraid of the people. We are the people. Revolutionaries do not talk to the people. They speak with the people, motherfuckers. So since y'all been with me since Revolutionary Volume 1, can I take y'all on a little journey with me? I can't fucking hear you. Just don't say that I didn't warn you. Put the kids to bed. Knew a nigga whose real name was William. His primary concern was making a million, being the illest hustler that the world ever seen. He used to fuck movie stars and sniff coke in his dreams. A corrupted young mind at the age of 13. Nigga never had a father and his mom was a fiend. She put the pipe down, but for every year she was sober. Her son's heart simultaneously grew colder. He started hanging out, selling bags in the projects, checking the young chicks, looking for hit and run prospects. He was fascinated by material objects, but he understood money never bought respect. He built a reputation because he could hustle and steal, but got locked once and didn't hesitate to squeal. Criminals he chilled with didn't think he was real. See, me and niggas like this have never been equal. I don't project my insecurities on other people. He fiended for props like addicts with pipes and needles. So he felt he had to prove to everyone he was evil. A feeble-minded young man with infinite potential, the product of a ghetto-bred capitalistic mental. Coincidentally, dropped out of school to sell weed. Dancing with the devil, smoked until his eyes would bleed. But he was sick of selling trees and gave it to his greed. I'm gonna tell you about my little homie. So Billy started robbing niggas anything he could do to get his respect back in the eyes of his crew. Starting fights over little shit up on the block. Stepped up to selling mothers and brothers to crack rock. Working overtime, making money for the crack spot. Hit the jackpot and wanted to move up to cocaine. But from the Scarface fantasy stuck in his brain. Tired of them hood niggas treating him the same. He wanted to be major like the cutthroats and the thugs. But when he tried to step to him, niggas showed him no love. He told him any motherfucking coward can sell drugs. Any nigga with a shirt in front like a blood. Even puppy smoked the motherfucker up in a club. But only a real dog to stab someone till they die. Standing in front of them, staring straight into their eyes. Billy realized that these men were well guarded, and they wanted to test him before business started. Suggested raping a chick to prove he was cold hearted. Now he had a choice between going back to his life or making money with made men up in his sights. His dreams about cars and ice made him agree. A hardcore nigga is all he ever wanted to be. So he met them Friday night at 2:45. Let's take this route. They rolled around the project slow while it was raining, smoking blunts, drinking, and joking for entertainment. Till they saw a woman on the street walking alone, 3 in the morning, coming back from work all the way home. So they quietly got up the car and followed her, walking through the projects. The darkness swallowed her. They wrapped her shirt around her head and knocked her onto the floor. This is it, kid. Now you got your chance to be raw. So Billy yoked her up and grabbed the chick by the hair. Dragged her into a lobby that had nobody there. Struggled hard, but they forced her to go up the stairs. Got to the roof and then they held her down on the ground. Yelling, shut the fuck up, stop moving around. The shirt covered her face, but she screamed and clawed. Billy stalked on the chick till he broke in her jaw. Them dirty bastards knew exactly what they were doing. They kicked her until they cracked her ribs and she stopped moving it. Blood leaking through the cloth, she cried silently. And then they all proceeded to rape her violently. Billy was made to go first, but each of them took a turn, ripping her up and choking her until her throat burned. Her broken jaw mumbled the guard, but they weren't concerned. When they were done and she was lying bloody, broken and bruised, one of them niggas pulled out a brand new 22. He told them that she was a witness of what she gone through, and if he killed her, he was guaranteed a spot in the crew. He thought about it for a minute, she was practically dead, so he leaned over and put the gun right to her head. Now I have to end the story for you, DC. The only way that it can end. Shit. Right before he pulled the trigger and ended a life, he thought about the cocaine with the platinum and ice. And he felt strong standing along with his new brothers. Cocked the gap to her head and pulled back the shirt cover. But what he saw made him start to cringe and stutter, because he was staring into the eyes of his own mother. She looked back at him and cried because he had forsaken her. She cried more painfully, and when they were raping her, his whole world stopped. He couldn't even contemplate his corruption had successfully changed his fate. And he remembered how his moms used to come home late, working hard for nothing, because now what was he worth? He turned away from the woman that had once given her birth and cried out to the sky because he was lonely and scared. But only the devil responded because God wasn't there. And right then he knew what it was to be empty and cold, and so he jumped off the roof, died with no soul. They say death takes you to a better place, but I doubt it. After that, they killed his mother and never spoke about it. And listen, because the story that I'm telling is true, because I was there with Billy Jacobs and I raped his mom too. Now the devil follows me everywhere that I go. In fact, I'm sure he's standing among one of you at my shows. And every street sniper listening to Lil Thug Slow could be standing right next to you and you wouldn't know. The devil grows inside the hearts of the selfish and wicked. White, brown, yellow, and black color is not restricted. You have a self-destructive destiny when you're inflicted. And you'll be one of God's children that fell from the top. There's no diversity because we're burning in the melting pot. So when the devil wants to dance with you, you better say never. Because a dance with the devil might last you forever. Obviously a very hard song to perform, but if you're going to hear anything that I have to say, please listen to what I have to say for the next 30 seconds. After every single show that I have, at least one person that was in their phone comes up to me and tells me, hey Technique, that's such a fucked up story, because they weren't paying attention. They say, is it a true story? I said, what do you mean? You're asking me if that happens? I tell them like this, of course it happens. It happens every day in every city, in every country, all over the fucking world. And I'm gonna make it more personal for the dudes in this room than for the women, because there are more dudes in the room than women. Let me make something personal for y'all motherfuckers. Your mother, your sister, your daughter, your grandmother, whoever you gonna marry someday, she might have lost her virginity by being a victim of rape or been a victim of that sometime during her life, and she might never tell you, man. You might never know, and it's because women are prouder than men, and they've been forced to suffer twice as much as we've had to during any fucking year. And as a matter of fact, we have never gotten our freedom in any society, in any revolution, anywhere around the world, without having our mothers, our daughters, our grandmothers, our cousins, right by our side, firing along with us for freedom in one way or another. So I tell people this, before you come to a hip-hop show and you think you're a commando or a rebel because you showed up, you make the changes, not that you just want to see the rest of the world and yourself first, but remember this. The next time that you at the bar getting drunk or whatever, that's not the time to be a tough guy. If you see somebody touching little kids at the park, you see somebody trying to drag a little girl into a van, that's not the time. That's the fucking time. It's not the time to try to be hardcore high at a party or trying to impress your friends. No, that's the time when you gotta step up like a motherfucking man and knock somebody's ass right the fuck out. Otherwise, you can never talk tough in your life ever again, my nigga. real shit. We don't fight the fights we can win. That's a coward's way out. You fight the fights that need fighting whenever they need fighting at whatever hour. That makes a revolutionary. Ladies and gentlemen, that's what I hope this room is for right now.